We begin with breaking news from the latest exclusive One News Kantar Public Poll. Numbers show the tide has turned in the race to run the country. The right bloc, National and ACT, for the first time in 2.5 years, getting enough seats to govern based on the poll results. And more bad news for the government, Jacinda Ardern's popularity continues to slide. Here's political editor Jessica Mutch-McKay with the numbers.
There's been a lot going on since our last poll at the end of May, so let's take a look and see how those numbers are looking. Top of the table is National on 37, but it's down 2 points. Labor's also dropped 2 and is now sitting on 33, its lowest number since 2017. ACT is back up, sitting on 11, a big bounce of 4. The Greens have dipped 1, but are still on 9 despite a messy leadership scrap. New Zealand First has climbed to 3, and Te Pāti Māori is steady on 2. So let's take a look at how some of the other smaller parties are doing. The Opportunities Party is steady on 2. Vision New Zealand is registering at about 1 for the first time. That's Hannah Tamaki's party. And the New Conservative and Democrats for Social Credit both get 1 each. But remember, 5% is the number needed to get into Parliament unless you win a seat. So let's move across now to the debating chamber and check this out, our new augmented reality 3D, all to make it easier for you at home to see how our latest poll numbers translate to seats in Parliament. With these results, there will be 48 National MPs here in blue. Add in the whopping 14 from ACT here in yellow, that's 62, which means National and ACT are above the 61 seats needed and could form a government. Te Pāti Māori would pick up 3 seats, 11 from the Greens, and Labour would bring in 44 MPs here in red, but even then, these three parties together wouldn't have enough to govern. That's how the seats in the House would look now, so let's bring up the preferred Prime Minister numbers. Jacinda Ardern has dropped to 30, her lowest rating as Prime Minister. Christopher Luxon dipped 2, he's now on 22. David Seymour has jumped up to 5. Winston Peters may not be in Parliament right now, but some still want him in the top job. And Chloe Swarbrick and National's Deputy Leader both get 1 each. So that's how the numbers have fallen in our winter poll.
You ready for it?
In an extraordinary television moment, National's leader turned musical.
And sums up how New Zealanders are feeling across this country. Got bills, I've got to pay. So I'm going to work, work, work every day.
That work is paying off. Voters shifting to the centre-right with a big dollop of support from ACT.
Kiwis are over this government and they want change.
The numbers are changing and not in the right direction for Jacinda Ardern and her party. She's been pressing the flesh around the world and handing out millions in cost of living payments. Despite that, Labor hasn't been this low since 2017, before Jacinda Ardern became leader.
These are record lows for Labor and for yourself. Do you think we've reached a turning point?
I do think that this is a reflection of the times.
After months of fun and games with leadership spills, National and ACT can form a government between them. They haven't been able to do that since before the pandemic. February 2020 to be exact, when National had 59 and ACT 2 in our poll.
To be 4 points ahead of Labor, I think, in this poll, that just says we've made great progress.
But it's not his dream result. He and the party are falling after weeks of talking about things he'd rather not, like his Hawaiian holiday and the abortion issue.
Do you think the abortion issue is a direct result of why you've dropped away 3 percentage points as preferred Prime Minister?
Well, look, we'll have a few ups and downs, and the first thing I'd say is I'm not a career politician.
And he won't say if this is his one tilt at the title.
If you lose the next election and can't form a government, will you resign as National leader?
I'm not thinking about anything other than just quarter by quarter.
Jacinda Ardern says she's got more than a year to sort it out, hinting to One News the election will be later in 2023.
I remain optimistic about our future despite these tough times.
And she'll need a good dose of optimism with these numbers.
And our political editor, Jessica Much-Mackay, joins us now. Jess, some big results there. What can we take from these figures overall?
This is a significant poll for Labor, and we're going to see some ripples behind the scenes. What it shows is that after 5 years in government, people are looking at their options. It's winter, people are feeling the pinch when it comes to the petrol pump, and prices are going up at the supermarket. And I also think it shows they've taken a bit of a hit on the way they doled out that cost of living payment, and it went to some people who just weren't eligible for it. For National, behind the scenes, they'll be feeling a bit of relief over this. It hasn't been a great few weeks, and they've made some mistakes. And I think that even though they'll be feeling a bit nervous about those preferred Prime Minister numbers with Christopher Luxon, ultimately, he will be Prime Minister on these numbers. And until now, that hasn't been a viable option. They don't want to be reliant on Te Pāti Māori. They'd much rather just have ACT, and on these numbers, they can do that.
Speaking of influence, let's look at the influential minor parties, the big ones among those. The Greens support pretty resilient, despite all those ructions we've seen with the co-leadership.
That's right. They've ditched their co-leader, James Shaw. They've publicly criticised him, and that support has really rusted in for the Green Party. So they're still sitting on a very comfortable 9, and that's an especially solid number when we're not even in an election year.
Arguably ACT the biggest winner in this poll. It's been percentage terms. It's voted way up. Why has it been so successful?
ACT is the biggest winner out of this. They will be feeling very chuffed with these results and will bring power to the table if these are the numbers on election night.